He is our combination domination, the combination being his last two starts. Back-to-back wins and back-to-back quality starts, each a career first for him. And look what he did against Texas, a career-high 9 strikeouts. And BIP, no walks in that start as well. And that had to be a pretty good feeling. Here's what the rookie had to say after that win.
Going game by game and trying to get better. And I've found how to get better and better myself, and I'm doing that right now. So it feels really good. Confidence is definitely rising.
What changes have you made these last couple starts to kind of get back on track, you think?
Well, just trying to attack that outside corner, even though if I miss, I probably miss up because I live up in the zone. But even when I miss, it's on the outside corner, not down the middle. So that was the biggest change.
I feel better to back up with a good start at home where you can kind of struggle this year.
Definitely. I was telling myself that walking off the field, like, it feels really good to, like, do this at home and just get the confidence going again.
You had some hitters that just swinging out of their shoes. Do you think you had some of your best stuff that you've had this season?
Oh, yeah, definitely. And, of course, those guys wanted to come into the ballpark today and, of course, prove something and swing. So I knew they were swinging at the get-go. So it was good to, like, throw my nasty stuff and not have them take that but swing and miss on those pitches.
All right, well, you heard Jharel Cotton say he was hitting the corners that he wanted to, but there are a few main ways that a starter could get the best of a hitter. I mean, he can just overpower him with pure stuff, change the eye level. We talk about that a lot by hitting all the corners, different spots in the strike zone. And then you can just fool them with speed, and that's what Jharel Cotton has in his back pocket as well.
Yeah, just the pitch selection was outstanding. Mm-hmm. He used a fastball to set up his changeup. And, you know, as a kid, this was one of my favorite cartoons because as a little leaguer, you're looking at Bugs Bunny and you're saying, wow, I'm going to check this out. And he always came with this little slow changeup. And that's just how Texas looked the other night against him because he had these guys with the breakdown swing. They were slamming their bat, throwing their helmet, looking out at him as if he was doing something wrong. But it had nothing to do with him. He just had one of these way above average changeups that at times is just unhittable.
Well, break it down now. Well, now we're going to look at the real Bugs Bunny changeup thanks to Squeaky. Appropriate nickname.
And look at Squeaky. When you talk about his release point, it's up high, but the ball has a tendency to just all of a sudden drop out of the strike zone. And as you see these hitters taking big swings, cracking bats, and getting frustrated, that's what a great changeup can do because you see it all the way. You think your timing is on it, but you just don't have a tendency to make contact. And as you see right there, these guys were swinging and missing. Helmets are flying. But all of that was set up by a really good fastball that he had, topping out around 93, 94, using it to the corners, and then coming back with either that good changeup or just a good curveball. Yeah. But the changeup, when he's out there and mentally he's got that confidence, like he said, the confidence is building, this is something special.
Yeah, well, the drop of the changeup is great. What's the speed differential, though, between his fastball and that change?
Well, I'd say he tops out around 93, 94 with his fastball, but the changeup is around 78.
Yeah.
So, again, these guys, when you talk about getting guys in a rocking chair, getting them out in front, changing speeds on them, he did an outstanding job with that.
Yeah, well, if he could put a third straight start together tonight, I think that would just do so well for him because it's a time that you can remember putting in your back pocket. So when struggles come in the future, and they will come next season, whatever, you just remember that. You get back to that feeling.
I call it putting deposits in the bank.
Yeah.
You know, when you need a withdrawal, you can go there and you can get it out. There's no problem. When he needs to think about, hey, how good am I? He can look back at these tapes and he can see what Jharel Cotton's all about. Okay.